lineup, this matchup between the Paquito and the Barats. In the long run, the Barats is favored, but if James plays this right, they could get an easy first blood. But Yaknu.
Yeah. Yaknu is taking a lot of shots from both Yawe and Renegade at the top lane, but Jay's also there to protect him. He went for a blender as his first kill, so we might expect a lot of leashes here on the side of Onik as he maybe at least at level 2 he can start going for those stuns, assisting Yaknu to get those stacks from the Avarice and also get those damage using the second skill there. So it's quite an even matchup for both teams right now, the early game.
Yeah, the interaction between their side lanes I see actually being taken advantage of once the cores come in. So here we see Hate just going for the purple first and then up into the orange. Great clear time, by the way. I appreciate how fast Hate has been going around the map. Dilar here, not a good look for him. He's already, what, a fourth of his health.
Yeah.
He can't trouble H2O, and James is currently pushing up into his lane. Again, if you play it right, even the counter to the Paquito is in trouble. But wait a second.
Oh, Exhort here in the middle lane. Up against Kyrie. Soul Bloom against the same umbrella open, which is, I guess, Exhort will have a much more better timing with that since the cooldown Soul Bloom is much more faster. As we look into the turtle lane, H2O starting things off, and Onik knew that the rest of NXP is already converging into that turtle lane. Look at the Guiding Wind into the Circling Eagle. Not that much damage, but the turret will help him out. They will secure the kill. James as well, really low, up against Dilar and Kyrie, but with the flicker and the umbrella, they will take that exchange one for one.
Right. Let's take this in reverse chronological order if Yaoi survives.
Uh-huh. And I think he will be forced out to use his flicker as Yaknu will dance away out of the turret.
All right. Yaoi, his flicker was used well. James, not so much. I think James was waiting for one more champ stance to come off, and then he gets a shield, and then he dodges the hell out of there.
Yeah.
But right then and there, again, there's too many sources of damage, at least two members of Onik sandwiching the Paquito, and he's happy to just have died. But again, he was hoping he was making the bigger play, and he used his flicker, but then still fell. I think mistakes like that are okay at the 3-minute mark, but wait, look at this top
lane. Oh, look at the top lane there. Renegade and Nexort doubling it up against Yaknu. 7 seconds in the side lanes, but that's a good kill for NXP because the gold lane has already been shut down. Well, this top lane is now free, and I think that's the reason why Akai, Jay, and Hate were there.
Yep, they were going to try to save Yaknu, but as it is, Renegade taking advantage of the window wherein he's stronger than the Esmeralda. Later on, it's going to be miserable. And later on, you're going to get shields. Esmeralda's going to eat him up. Yaknu's going to have a field day. And just like that, I think this just shows how high of a game IQ NXP has.
Oh, look at that. Nice jump out from the Wailing Dragon here by Yaoi, even helping the Concussive Blast. But H2O will secure the kill here in the bottom lane. 4-4-1 Leo at the moment. And slowly NXP trying to pull their net worth up away from Onik.
To be fair, this is a draft that is down the wire. Mm. Both teams have had their own fair share of chokes. Both fair share of hero steals. But yeah, the way NXP is playing, it's very, very their style. You know, early kills, early trades, but less a trade. But
look at Yaoi here getting choked inside the wall using the Hurricane Dance, but that's not enough. James with the knockout strike, trying to disable most of the members of Onik PH, but not that much damage. But NXP, for not on the very good position after that fight in the turtle. And Onik, just with their really tanky heroes, Dilar as well, assisting the rest of Onik PH to survive that fight.
Say what you will about Hate, especially when it's clutch time, but he played that team fight well. Yes, H2O got the turtle. Yes, they could have gotten away with more, especially after locking in Yaoi. But Onik played that the best they could, and it shows in their gold. It shows in their gold. Look, look, literally, it's less than 500 gold in between these two teams. It could be worse given the 4-2 record and 100% turtle take for NXP. So Onik, they're so used to playing from behind. They're so used to making the most of the situation. How will they translate?
Oh, Circling Eagle to Zaman Force. And I think this is how they will translate things here. Yaknu still alive. But look at Yaoi taking a lot of damage from the turret. But with the help of the Guiding Wind, a little bit off angle. But Exhort will absorb the damage from the flame shot. It was a nice attempt though.
Close.
Really close attempt. from NXP. But with the turret, with the disable from Onyx, they're successfully able to save one of their members.
Yep, that is the future special. That is how Kairi does things. Again, flame shot, maximum range, a kill from out of nowhere. But I think NXP has been watching enough of Onyx PH games to know exactly what's up. Thinking about it on Onyx side, though, they are sitting at 4-2. They have alleviated a little bit of pressure from their scaling gold laner. Yakno able to move a little bit more around the map. But we have yet to see him actually do anything. He's sitting at 0-1-0 just yet. We're seeing more Dilar become a threat slowly. Mm. And James here, his time as the dominating Paquito is slowly ticking away.
Yeah, and he really needs to get those stacks from the Festival of Blood for him to at least sustain much more of the damage of Onyx PH, because once we've reached the mid game to late game, those damage, look at the items here. Clock of Destiny heading straight into a Lightning Truncheon there for Kairi, and that's the biggest threat. You also have an additional skill using the Flame Shot that can secure any kills if you get the right shot.
Yep, and as it is, turtle of the game. To be fair, DDZ, we're only 40 seconds off of full turtles. Again, 2 minutes every turtle, right?
Yeah.
This is a great look for NXP.
Hold that thought, Leo, because Jay, with a circling eagle, able to take down James. It's on its well, composing H2O, but it will not connect. And the turtle will be taken. NXP, again, with those small skirmishes on the near the turtle area, but with the Zaman Force, Iyaknu soaking, draining all the energy shields out of Renejay and using it here for herself, and Iyaknu will be alive. But what happened from that fight, man? I really thought that it's in favor of NXP.
Yeah, if I may say, first up, NXP, the turtle wasn't worth it. They weren't able to capitalize. They weren't able to translate as much. They lost bottom lane, and now they're going to take top. At least they're catching up. And this is best case scenario for NXP. Mm. For Onyx, I think they're still in control. They still understand how they need to get there, what they need to do. And Jay, another sandwich.
Oh, Hurricane Dance with Yaoi. Able to with the flicker. Plus a Jinkudo combo into Wave the Dragon. Jay flickering it out. But Dilar here with the Detonate Welcome. Shutting down H2. Well, that's the main target. The Yaoi will secure the kill. 25 second sidelines for H2O. But Onyx with a nice counterplay.
Exactly.
From NXP.
This is what I was talking about. They are losing turtles. They are losing turrets. But they know where else on the map to take pieces so that they can have an engine of their own. And currently, it's Dilar right now, man. They're saying, Gerald, my boy, General, man, we need you to start owning bottom lane, and we also need you to start catching people on guard, whether it be Yaoi, whether it be Renejay, or better yet, if it's H2O, please use Zitona's Welcome right then and there. Jay's going to play Diversion, and they've got that. They've got that at least half the time that they tried, and they've only started doing that very, very recently. But just the same, I want to see Iyaknu do more. Iyaknu is a huge key to the Onyx game plan here. They're playing the long game, TDZ.
Yeah.
We see Onyx dominate. It's going to happen around the 11-12 minute mark, but that's only if NXP allows it.
Yep, it really depends on NXP now and all about the position. But look at Exhort here taking a lot of shots. But Yaoi with a Wave of the Dragon isolating Dilar. And he will be bursted out with the Soul Bloom. Jay trying to do his best to protect his teammate. But again, the Yin Yang overturn. Catching out four, but Hate out of position. H2O might get killed. Or rather, he will get the kill onto Hate. And NXP with a nice mobility, counting every step of the Onyx PH and capitalizing on the situation. However, NXP looking for more, trying to get out James, or rather, Iyaknu. James at his tail, but they will disengage for now.
I'll give round two here to NXP. Earlier, it was Onyx who did the rope-a-dope, especially after they picked off H2O. With the same round, H2O, he was looking for vengeance. He knew exactly how to get it. And again, we saw Hate earlier use the Eye for an Eye just perfectly to survive an onslaught from Exhort. But this time around, if it's H2O, he means business. These are just basic attacks. He didn't even need to use he didn't even trigger the passive. It was all just basics after a Traceless.
Yeah, and since he also went, or he already had the Blade of Despair, already working out the Endless Battle, so that's a lot of crits, a lot of damage that the H2O can dish out. But look at this, Iyaknu against Yaoi. Jeet Kune Do will hit. Let's wave the dragon, but not the right angle, as H2O and the rest of NXP will hide inside the brushes. Renejay was also there, plus Exhort, but the rest of Onyx PH will just disengage. Look at the discipline from Onyx PH now. Mm-hmm.
they know exactly how to play this position, TDZ. Mm-hmm. They know how it is to be from behind. They know that they are down about 2,000, but they know where to look for it. Hate here taking his purple. That is some slight silver lining, given how much NXP is slowly choking out Onyx. But look at this up top.
Oh, top three members with a circling eagle. Iyaknu, he might survive. No, says Renege as he take down the life using the chrono dashes plus the synchro fission. And after taking down the top lane, they will go straight to the back as Yaoi set things up with the Jeet Kune Do plus the way the Dragon Dilar will be forced to use his Tetonus Welcome. Nice try with the Shunpo, but a double knockup. Yin Yang overturn, but Yaoi will mess things up with the Jeet Kune Do. Three-man Jeet Kune Do and NXP. Oh, what a flame shot from Kairi.
From down
just
south.
At the nick of time.
From down south.
3 points from down south.
Exhort, nothing but net. Earlier, Exhort blocked it, but this time around, he blocked it, and he had to pay with his life. This is good for Onyx PH. That extended, prolonged team fight led to Exhort being KIA, MIA from this first Lord. 11 minutes, 40 seconds in. How can they go for a contest? It's Yak
game. As we go straight back to the game here, Jay with the Hurricane Dance. James forced to use the Flicker. Able to disengage from that initiation from Onyx PH, but the Detonus Welcome will be pulled. I think that is H2O. No, that is James. But yeah, we're taking a lot of shots. James will be down for the count as Iyaknu taking a lot of damage as well as the Circling Eagle will land. Three hero knockup from NXP, but Iyaknu will still be alive. But Renege getting that pickoff on Hate.
The Hitman.
Oh, the Hitman himself.
Assassinating the jungler from Onyx. Honestly, I was watching the Lord fight. I was watching the almost kill on Iyaknu, but TDZ, the real action was in the side lane right there in that very small corner of the minimap where the Hitman, Renege, was able to take down Hate almost single-handedly. Now there's a team fight breaking out.
Yep, team fight it is. Jay will be taken out by the traces of H2O as Onyx PH will try to disengage. Will they fight? Since they're looking at NXP taking down the Lord, half HP now, as James trying to isolate Kairi, forced to use the Rush Umbrella Flea, but look at H2O, nice attempt from the Flame Shot still, but H2O said, no, I still have my Retribution, and NXP will have the momentum, 37k against 33.5.
Kairi, we've seen him do much more difficult things in much more dire situations, but this time around, love the effort, but as you mentioned, H2O, the words left his mouth, but he made it say it with his actions. Retribution right then and there. It was so easy. There were three members of NXP. But for Onyx PH, TDZ, the answer here for them is to bolster in. Hunker down, prepare for this Lord defense, and save as much of your turret, save as much of the base as you can. But again, you mentioned, what is that, a 4K, 5K gold lead?
Yeah.
That's at least, what, two items on their core.
Exactly. That's how far NXP is right now. But let's look at the top lane and the middle lane. It's a little bit of a split as the Jeet Kune Do will connect to the top lane here, isolating Iyaknu, but Iyaknu has a lot of shields on his arsenal. And look at the Lord, the Luminous Lord, bang! It will hit into the tier 3 turret, half of the HP of that turret, as James here will take down the tier 2 turret on the mid lane. It's more of a sandwich, a split play here from NXP, as with the Diamond Force plus the dashes, taking down the tier 3 turret. Nice attempt here for NXP, but with the Hurricane Dance, will it be enough? Says no, and also H2O able to secure another kill here at the top lane. And also Iyaknu chasing down H2O, but H2O's HP is still at full. But nice attempt from NXP, isolating Onyx.
It still ended up in a trade. They took bottom lane turret. It was James for Hate. That's a trade I'll take any day, all right? Including Tuesdays. I'm usually off on Tuesdays. But for this one, NXP, chef's kiss. Ooh. They made the right kind of play. They distracted Onyx Philippines, and they forced, again, Iyaknu, who would have been great in that team fight down bottom. There were, like, what, three or four people to steal shields from, but again, it was off camera. I don't know what H2O was doing, how he forced Iyaknu to answer back. So for, in some sense, it was an isolation play from the jungler on the gold laner. 15 minutes in, looking at Iyaknu's numbers, 2-2-0, Again, the reason why I know it's H2O who did it is because he didn't use his Purify.
Oh.
So if it was someone else, it was like James or something, then yeah, but wait, Dilar gets
picked
up.
Oh, Dilar gets picked up. Diamond Force has been used, but Dilar is way too tanky. But look at Jay here with the Mountain Shocker, providing information for NXP how to react in this engagement. But NXP says no, just hold out a little bit. Look at the items here, Leo.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of items already. And I think Renegade will go for the other Azure Blade, go into a Thunderbelt.
Yep, this is an interesting build. Again, he has an Oracle, so he knows that he wants to stay in the fight for a long time. And yes, that is going to be a Thunderbelt, his last item. On the other side, Onyx Philippines, it's a toss-up. Actually, Dilar has been been able to farm up really well for himself, as well as Iyaknu. I couldn't say the same as much for Hate, but that just shows that here's a silver lining for Onyx Philippines. They're able to still step out of their base.
Mm.
Imagine if you were Hate in this situation, 16 minutes in, you couldn't even try to contest your purple, which I believe NXP should go ahead and choke. Yes, they will.
Oh, they will use the Mountain Shocker, but look at the Circling Eagle here. Exort getting picked off, but Exort HP, or the shields from the Guiding Wind, helped him to get out of the sticky situation from Onyx PH. But the next objective will respawn in the next 24 seconds. Who will get the better position here?
Yep, I think NXP again just has a better go. By hook or by crook, Onyx, it's not like they don't have any contest. It's just that by the way the past two or three teamfights have gone, NXP has had their number. Now, what can Onyx do? One is, again, make Dilar the center of attention and eat up at least H2O or Renegade, one or the other.
Yeah,
H2O or Renegade. If it's anyone else, they're more likely to survive. That's one. Number two is Kairi, stay out of the team fight. If anything, just deal damage from afar and then try to seal with the flame shot, but now it's broken out.
Oh, broken up indeed, as again, another Abor, another Jeet Kune Do, plus the Wind of the Dragon here, NXP with a nice stun from Jay. Double Hurricane Dance for Jay there, disabling NXP, and Yaoi trying to get the attention of Onyx. Hit me instead. But look at James here, going for a sandwich play, hitting out three. Another Detonus welcome here, eating up James, pulling, pushing him at the side. But the double Jeet Kune Do knockup, and James again with a knockout strike, disabling two enemy heroes, but they're way too tanky. Iyaknu with a lot of shields here as well, and it's really difficult for them to take anyone out. But Hate looking for Renegade hiding inside the brush, but with the knockout strike again. Oh, like the final blow, catching, disabling the next step. NXP, Yaoi trying to run away, and Jay is there with the Hurricane Dance. Exort with his mobility, really making it difficult for Onyx to get another pick off. But that's a 2-4-1 kill for Onyx.
This is the best Onyx has gotten out of huge team fights. Call it a trade if you want to. They did lose Kairi, but this is the best that they've gotten in the past 5 minutes?
Oh, yeah.
Give or take, they take down Renegade. They shut down H2O. It's a lot of gold that they caught up to. They've closed the gap at about 3,000 now in between NXP and Onyx, but they have a Luminous Lord marching down bottom. Could have been worse, really, for NXP. It's just that Onyx Philippines, they're so disciplined. They're showing us that they don't have to force it unless they know that they can take advantage. But again, all they did was regain much of the map. And did Hate get his purple? Oh no, Exort stole it!
Yeah, Exort stole
it! Exort
stole it! As a lot of skirmishes happening here, all heroes trying to poke down and kite NXP and also Onyx PH, but NXP, James here occupying the orange buff of Onyx PH, choking them out of the course buff. But James playing around Dilar, both of the heroes can't kill each other, but at least getting a different position here as Jay going for a Hurricane Dance. I think that's his Exort who got trapped inside the wall. Immortality will pop. But look at round two. Missile Expert pushing Jay back. And also James will secure the kill here. But H2O up against Iyaknu. H2O needs to run away. But with a flame shot from Kairi, securing the kill here. Iyaknu has a lot of shields right now, converting into his HP. However, here in the bottom lane, Renegade,
The Hitman
will secure another kill under his name. 45 seconds without H2O, 55 for Dilar, and Jay with 28. But the tier 3 turret is now in the eye, eyeing for NXP. And Jay got killed by Hate with the help of the Yin Yang Overturn as Exort moving towards Kairi here. Soul Bloom damage is not enough as Exort still trying to run away. Winter Truncheon grow as a player, says Exort here. But the isolation play from NXP, Yaoi with the Jeet Kune Do plus the Wave of the Dragon, Iyaknu still looking for more, not tired at all, as Yaoi will still disengage with the help of Exort's Guiding Wind.
Leo.
I was about to say that that catch by Jay was the worst timed Hurricane Dance, but I ate my words immediately. I'm glad I didn't say it out loud as it was part of the fight because, yes, it was early. Yes, there were no follow-throughs, but it was enough for Onyx to retaliate. It was enough for Onyx to come in and, again, take the two core damagers from NXP, which slowly but surely will allow Onyx to catch back up. And that's going to be key here to give Hate and to give Iyakno the items and the time they need to be able to get back into this battle. And with that being said, DDG, that's it. Hate and Onyx, they've locked up their arsenal. This is all they need. Potions aside, this is the best shape Onyx can be to contest for this Lord. And once more, they have closed the gap. Just now, barely 1,000.
Woo. And that was 5k before, right?
Yeah.
Or more than 5k, actually.
Yeah.
But Onyx Page able to catch things up, even playing from behind. Look at the turrets here, ladies and gentlemen. All the outer turrets of Onyx Page has been destroyed. Only two remaining inner turrets
at half
right
health.
There. At half health. So that's how fast, or that's how crucial Onyx Page life for game one is, as NXP now at that attack position, trying to pick off. Oh, with the pick off there from Dilar. But again, I think that was the flicker burn there just to prevent the right angle from Yaoi isolating from the rest of Onyx. But NXP really careful now as Onyx still wants to go for a risky play.
Yep, TDZ, I love the way Onyx has forced NXP to split up. That was a wave pushed in, created, orchestrated by Iyakno down bottom, which made James actually spend some time there, clear it up the old-fashioned way, and then answer. Now NXP, they are back at neutral, both teams. They are jockeying for position here on this Lord Hate all the way down, looking to replicate what Iyakno did. But, yeah, I don't think NXP's having any of this unless I think the next play here for next play is to go for a pickoff.
Yep.
We are in TikTok timers.
Yeah, TikTok timers already open. 22 minutes here, ladies and gentlemen.
I didn't notice.
So the respawn timer, if you got, well, if you got killed, you just need to look at your screen or possibly go for a TikTok since you have much time to deal with. But 13 to 11, you see how everything changes after the 20-minute mark. And if you don't have the immortality, that will punish you a lot because immortality is the key here once we reach the 20-minute mark. Starting things off with a Mountain Shocker, trying to provide information for NXP.
Hold up, look at this. Iyakno, 2v1, now it turns into a 4v2. What a turn of events.
And also Exort needs to run away from this one. Guiding Wind on top of that wall. Hurricane Dance has been used already. Perfect kill here for Onyx PH as James and Yaoi trying to help each other. Trying to run away from Iyakno, but look at the Lord. Surprise, surprise. That's Iyakno. I'm here. You need to stop the Lord now. But Kairi able to rush Umbrella Flea out of that situation from Yaoi and James. But look at Hate here getting isolated. And Renegade will secure that kill. The Chrono Dash is here, man. And also the slow from the Thunder Belt really helped him out to catch out against Hate.
Yep. More than a minute on the death timer of Hate. The Hitman always gets his man, and I was afraid, honestly, for NXP because they were engaging without ults. You saw that. That's how strong this Baratz is in this current metagame. That's how strong Dilar is playing this Baratz. He forced all the ults out of NXP, but it seems like that point is moot.
Yeah.
Onyx lost on Lord. They did go for a trade. They took out Exort. They are now going to have to once more decide. How are we going to defend this? This is round two all over again. This was the same situation we found themselves in maybe 10 minutes earlier. Now, they did it back then. I don't doubt that they can do it here.
Yeah.
I'm sure that they'll find a way.
Yeah, they will find a way as the Lord slowly marching into the bottom lane here and the rest of NXP again with a split play. Two members at the top, three members down at the middle. But Yaoi, again, trying to start things off with another Hurricane Dance, immediately popping the immortality of H2O. H2O down for NXP, but the rest of Onyx Page still alive. Iyakno with a lot of shields here, absorbing the shields of Renegade from the key inside. But look at this, Stardust Dance. Isolation play here from Yaoi, but Iyakno has the Purify, still focusing on Renegade. Renegade able to get to the other side, but Iyakno will also get there with the Falling Star Moon, but Iyakno still not done. Double knock-up here from Yaoi, but still trying to soak all the shields. Iyakno is still standing tall.
He's relentless!
He's relentless! Just sticking behind. I'll be at your tail until you get to your main base. But look at how far Iyakno went for those kills.
What a bully!
What a bully indeed.
And this is what we were talking about during the draft. If Iyakno finds a way to become the beast he has right here, right now, to become this beast here, then Onyx Philippines might actually have an easy go. I mean, the past 15 minutes have been disastrous. The past 15 minutes have been difficult, but they're still in the game, and you just saw how Iacno bullied three members of NXP.
Oh, look at that. Canceling the Hurricane Dance with a Jeet Kune Do. Perfect timing from Yaoi, but Renny J here dodging the Thousand Clash plus the Blender combo, but look at Kairi getting isolated. He might get killed here. Yaoi will secure the kill. Xtar trying to run away, but look at James here. Getting isolated by four members of Onyx PH. He's still trapped, trying to run away, getting that life still up, but the growth. Oh, the Winter Truncheon will save the growth as a player. Growth player motto is now being used, not even by the tank, but it's a fighter, so it's a little bit Pseudo's playstyle there, itemization from NXP, but it works!
Yeah.
It works, Leo, it works!
That seems to be like a small subculture of our metagame currently. Give fighters, frontliners, the Winter Truncheon, right? Damn all the stats it gives! I just want that suppress. I just want to be invulnerable for a few seconds, and now they catch Dilar.
Oh, again with the nice Way of the Dragon, isolating Dilar, but Dilar is way too tanky. Look at the damage here being dealt by Xtort with the Soul Bloom. Slowly looking down Iacno. Can he pop the Frostmoon Shield? Yes, he will. Slowly returning his HP, but Jay will pop his Immortality. Is he ready for round two? Jay with a 1,000 Pounder plus a Tai Chi, getting enough shield for him to disengage from NXT's engagement. But Hate here moving forward, trying to go for James, but with a nice Missile Expert disjoining the rest of NXP. Another falling Star Moon, but the damage output from Iacno, can he survive this? Circling Eagle, a lot of ultimates now being absorbed by Iacno, but it's okay, says NXP. I'm still alive, but we have flame shot again from Kairi.
The future
is enough. Xtort is down, so NXP will disengage.
It still turns into a trade, but I love the awareness. I love the way Kairi just knows, all right? He's like a Terminator.
Yeah, he's like a Terminator.
Kairi,
scanning.
The Terminator. Target acquired. Flame shot. Exactly. Amazing. In that kind of situation, most other players, I'm just saying this in general terms, would have thrown the skills into the huge scramble in the mid.
Yeah.
But alas, it seems like Kairi has made a blood feud. It seems like he has marked Xtort for death since minute one. I will have you. You are my man. Flame shots, it has your name on it, and it all resulted into a trade. Lovely play here by Onyx Philippines. Now they're gonna try to go for another. I'm excited to see how Jay will sandwich two or three, maybe four people again. Once more, Way of the Dragon now.
Way of the Dragon plus the Mountain Shocker providing information, but Jay is way too tank already. But the next objective will be this Lord. It will reset as Onyx PH. And also Renny J, again, you need to keep an eye on Renny J here. He can take down turrets as fast as possible with the help of the Zaman Force. But Onyx knew that, okay, we just need to make sure that there will be no split pushes as Iacno TP it out and defend the top lane.
Yep, that's going to be the last safe haven Onyx PH has. And so far, Iacno has been great. I do believe, just the lineup on Onyx, it's not meant to clear waves. They don't have a Chang'e, they don't have a Farsa. So whenever they clear waves, they do it the old-fashioned way, which makes it all the more meaningful for them. And it has to be a call. It has to be a move that the whole team agrees to, and so far that's what we've been seeing from them. The past 10 minutes, they have been orchestrating defenses, they've been orchestrating clears, but right now, Detonus welcome!
Oh, Detonus welcome into Xtort. Xtort get bursted out, half HP, but he does have the Winter Truncheon, because the Missile Expert will try to displace him for a little bit, but Xtort will be the main focus fire of Onyx, and Hate will be successful taking down the head of Xtort for the next 89 seconds. There's no mobility now for NXP, but with the use of the Jeet Kune Do plus the Way of the Dragons, canceling Dilar, but they need to make it a constant damage so the healing will not proc itself. But H2O alone inside the Onyx territory, but Hate with the mobility, Phantom Slashes plus Iacno's assist, they will secure that kill. 2-4-0 exchange. And do you think, Leo, that it's the right time for Onyx to get that Lord?
Yes, they have a free go at the Lord, especially looking at how both Xtort and H2O, as they fell, took what? A minute and a half. I don't know how NXP will contest this Lord. At this point, it's a crapshoot. It's 50-50.
It is.
Right now, especially with Onyx, the way Iacno has been dominating teamfights, how they're just isolating, how they I don't even know how they isolated H2O. That was something that was beautiful. But wait, look, there's three members of NXP here. This could be a disaster or could be a miracle steal. TDZ.
Let's see with the Way of the Dragon here. Kairi, Rash Umbrella of Lee. But look at the HP of that Lord. Lord will be taken by Kairi. What a guy. Not even with the Flame Shot, but Renegade got disabled. Hurricane Dance. Where's the rest of Onyx PH? Now they're there. So-called teamwork, but Zaman Force will be forced out. But Yaoi overextending, trying to be as annoying, pulling all of their attention, buying some time for NXP to at least get a breather. But Yaoi, in exchange for the time, he'll be down for the next 90.
Run, Yaoi, run. Could have been maybe one more lap, I'm thinking. Maybe he was a second off of the cooldown on the Shunpo. But yeah, it's difficult to steal a Lord from a team with a player specifically that's predisposed to steal Lords. I'm talking about Kairi. Kairi has stolen Lords in the MPL Season 7 that he had no business taking, all right? And three fighters, mind you, three fighters and two fighters and Harith. I don't know how else they thought they could have done that. But right now, TDZ, this is Onyx now in the driver's seat.
Indeed, as they're waiting for the Lord to go to the bottom lane. Almost a mirror move here for Onyx PH as Hate will also try to control or push out the lane at the top as the rest. Oh, the damage from Renegade! You need to be careful because Kairi can easily burst you out with the combo. But Onyx here still standing tall as the Luminous Lord, bang! Hitting that tier 3 turret out of the way as the Onyx will pave way into that opening. But look at the damage here from James. Three times knockout strike there, but the damage is not enough. Look at the Eagle. Exploit moving forward, got isolated from the rest of the team as NXP. Okay, Winter Truncheon, but for sure, he'll be picked off against.
Looking pretty ugly.
Yep, really tight indeed as the rest of the minions isolating H2O. With Immortality, says no. Onyx PH now at the comfort zone, trying to go for the end here. Trying to end things out, but the Hate will get isolated. Now he's now being chased by James here, or I think that's Yaoi. Yaoi indeed, but James trying to control the rest of the flow of the creep wave here. Dilar, Jay is also there. He does have the immortality, but Yaoi and also Kairi. I think Kairi's the main target here. Another flame shot, not enough damage, but again, enough to take down the immortality of Renegade. And the main inhibitor is now exposed as Onyx PH will try to clear things out, waiting for the next creep wave to pull up, but says no. Jay will just go straight for the ham. Onyx PH will secure game one against Execration.
There was just so much.